Well, today I have an excellent Fast Friday for you, all about Face Eye Auto Detect on the Fujifilm camera. Hi everyone, welcome to Pal to Tech. There are five modes of Face Eye Auto Detect on the camera. They're located in the menu under AF/MF on page 2 at the top right here. The first one is off, meaning face detection is off and eye detection is off. Basically, the entire thing is off and the camera shoots like this feature doesn't exist whatsoever. This is the default mode of your camera when you first purchase an X-T3 or X-T4. The second one is face on, eye off. This tells the camera to search out and find faces in your photos. Once a face is recognized, you will see a green square around the face. If you have more than one face in your photo, your Fujifilm camera will choose the face that's closest to the center of the frame. They are still recognized as faces, but the camera is focusing on the face with the green square. Next on the list is Face On, Eye Auto. This is the mode that actually I use the most often and I find generally works the best. In this mode, the camera not only recognizes the face, but it also recognizes the subject's eye. It will try and focus on the eye closest to the front of the frame. If, for whatever reason, say the subject is wearing glasses and the eye cannot be recognized, then the camera will fall back and simply recognize it as a face and focus in on that. The final two on the list are almost identical, so I'll talk about them at the same time. Face on right eye and face on left eye focuses on the specific eye of your subject. So, for example, if you have it set to face on left eye, the camera will focus on the subject's left eye. This is from the perspective of the subject. It's the subject's left eye. Therefore, if you, the photographer, are looking through the viewfinder, it will show up as the right eye being focused on. Makes sense, right? Now, the way Face Eye Auto Detect works with focus modes is pretty simple. If you have the focus mode set to manual, then there is no Face Eye Auto Detection at all. It simply won't work. So that leaves us with the other two modes, continuous and single. With autofocus mode of S for single, the camera will follow the face while you half press the shutter button. At that point, it will lock focus, after which you could then recompose the shot and then continue pressing the shutter down the remainder of the way to take the picture. If you have the focus mode set to continuous C autofocus, then the camera will continue to follow the face and continue to focus wherever the subject moves while you're half pressing the shutter button. Let me show you what I mean by that. I'm going to put the camera in S autofocus mode right here, and I'm going to turn on Face Eye Auto Detect. I'm going to press and hold down the shutter button. Now I'm going to move the camera closer, and as you can see, I'm going out of focus, right? It doesn't follow. Now I'm gonna put it in continuous autofocus mode. Let's do the same thing we just did. I am pressing and holding down halfway the shutter button. And as I move in, the camera follows me. I'm always in focus. You see that? Always in focus. I find it much better when shooting Face Eye Auto Detect to have the focus mode set to C. I think that's better than having it set to S in a lot of cases. I strongly recommend that you assign a custom button to quickly access Face Eye Auto Detect. On my X-T4, I set my custom button for this using the top button right here. And like always, you can customize these buttons to whatever you like by pressing and holding down the DISP back button for a few seconds and then making your changes in the menu that appears. There is an additional setting that not a lot of people know about. It's called Face Select, and you have to assign it to a custom button. But once you do, and you activate Face Select by pressing the custom button, then this will allow you to use either the joystick or the touch screen to select other faces in your scene. So for example, instead of choosing what the camera selected as the green face here, I could simply quickly toggle toggle the face select button and then move my joystick to select the other face and turn it green. And there's also a little trick with this. If you assign face select to a custom button and then you press that button, even when you're not in face eye auto detect mode, it will turn on face eye auto detect mode for you. Here are four additional tips that I have for you to consider when shooting with face eye auto detection. Number one, with regard to exposure, the camera will tend to set your exposure based on the face portion of your scene. If you don't want the camera to set the exposure of your entire shot based on just the face, then make sure that you're manually setting your aperture, ISO, and shutter speed so that you can override that. Number two, let's say the camera is unable to detect a face in your scene or loses face detection while you're in the middle and trying to compose a shot. In those cases, it will then switch back to whatever autofocus mode you previously had set it for, such as single point, zone, wide tracking, etc., whatever you have. Number three, whenever you play back on your LCD screen a shot that you just took, it will show you this label right here if it was successful in detecting a face during the shot. If you press the down button on the selector buttons pad, it will show you the primary face that it recognized when it took the shot. If you have a group of people, you can also zoom in by pressing it one more time. You can also jump from face to face by continuing to press the down button. That's a great way to check to see if all of your faces are in focus. Number four, face eye auto detect works very similar in video mode as well. I'll be going more into detail on that in future tutorials about shooting movies, but for now, remember that once you start shooting and the camera's, you know, actually rolling, you cannot change face eye auto detect while it's filming. You have to set face eye auto detect before you press the shutter and begin filming your movie. Remember, face eye auto detect can make mistakes and it's never a substitute for learning the regular focus modes of your camera. I have a whole video on focus modes of the X-T3, X-T4 that I'll put a link to that tutorial video in the description down below in this video. With face eye auto detect, you always want to be careful if you're shooting multiple people that are in different areas, front and back of your focus, especially if they're moving around. But if you've not yet tried out Face Eye Auto Detect, you definitely should. It works very well most of the time, and it's actually the best mode to put your camera in if you're traveling and you have to hand it to a stranger to take a picture of you. It makes it easier for non-photographers to not screw up the shot. Well, that'll do it for this video. I hope you found this helpful. If you did, be sure to give it the like and subscribe. Have a wonderful weekend. And as far as next week is concerned, capture one. Oops, excuse me. Sorry about that. Have a great weekend. I'll see you real soon. Take care.
Am I right? You're right.
You're confusing the camera. Interesting how it's not catching me yet.
I am more magnetic to
it. It's preferring you.
It prefers me. The camera loves me.
Oh, there,
it just loves me. Hey.
Okay, can it detect the face? Nope, not a chance.